Well, hello, Bob Dendry here, and welcome back to Transport Fever 2, where we are building the Reno, Thousand Oaks and Roseville Railway. So last week we did a whole lot of work around the Fontana Junction, which I think looks really good. We also did some optimization of our brick station over at Roseville, and we're going to continue doing a bit of that in the early part of this episode as well. So let's jump in and have a look. So you'd remember we have quite a glut of bricks right now. So we have, you know, if we have a look at our good station here, we've got hundreds of bricks just sitting here waiting to be transported. And we've started to take advantage of that by getting some new trains on that are sort of the longest length we can have them. But we can do a bit more as well, I think. And one thing that we've probably forgotten about, or maybe not so much forgotten about, but it hasn't been a priority, is our stone coming in. And we've got a lot of sort of waiting that's happening when our train departing from Roseville is waiting for the train coming towards Roseville to pass through. So we're going to double track this short section of track here going through to Roseville Transfer. And that should allow us to, make this sort of short trip a lot more efficient, as it should be, being such a short, you know, length of a track that our trains need to run on. So I am going to quickly pause because I'm going to break a few things. But overall, this should be a really quick and easy change we can make. At least I thought it was. Apparently, not really liking this. So that's interesting. It's not wanting to run parallel. Okay, I think it's okay now. And so we're just going to basically make some nice, easy connections here. We're saying too much slope. Oh, wow, that is quite a bit of slope, isn't it? Doesn't look like that much, does it? Until you bend it in there. So we might need to slightly realign this. But I think it'll still be fairly simple connection to make. Still saying too much slope. Why is it doing that? That's like ridiculous. Might need to do some slight fixing, I think. And with these changes made, they should pretty much allow, more or less, sort of constant running, I guess you could call it. So that's fixed the issues. We'll unpause and we'll just get signaling in while we are waiting there, I guess. And now we just need to connect our other line up, which should be fine. I don't foresee us having any issues doing this, but, you know, you never know. To be honest, this isn't a massively important connection anyway, because we're not even running any trains in that direction. But we're fixing it. We might potentially want to access some more stone in the future. So yeah, helps to have that available. Now, by fixing this, our trains can run constantly back and forth. There's not going to be any waiting, as traditionally our train heading back from Roseville over here has had to wait at this this passing loop. But that shouldn't be an issue now. And now that we've done that, I also want to look at changing over some of our trains. So on our Fontana brick line here, we've got a 50-year-old train. So we're going to get that one replaced, get a nice shiny new train on there. And there we go. Next, we've definitely got a lot of trains over here that need replacing. These are going to be like heading towards 100 years old, surely. 66 years old, so we'll get you fixed up. What we could potentially actually do is just sell this one altogether and clone our existing train running on that line. Oh, not enough money. Okay, well, we should be fairly close, I would assume. Have a look, what are you worth? Yeah, very close, very close. In fact, we're not going to just clone that because we're not going to be using GP9s. This is a... It's sort of a less important line. So if we had some spare GP9s, we could potentially switch those over to run on this line and put SD40s on something else. That's actually an option. So let's have a look and see what we've got available if we pop out of this. I'm sure we've got some GP9s running on one of these lines coming out of Roseville that we could potentially switch on to be an SD40. And so we've got this one here that we could switch over to be an SD40, and we can use the GP9 on one of our fuel trains instead. We might do that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to buy a single vehicle, an SD40. Like so, we're going to assign this to our line, which was Roseville to Hollywood Bricks, I want to say. Let's pop over and just check it, make sure it's the right one. Roseville, Hollywood Bricks. So I'm going to assign this new SD40 to that line. And now what I'm going to do, we're going to manage our vehicles on the line. And we are going to switch all of our flat cars down to sit on this new train. I will also lengthen this as well, actually. So I'll bump it up to a 242-meter long train. Which apparently already was, I just missed some carriages that were already there, so we'll modify that. Then we're just going to have this GP9 that is just sitting here. And what we can do then is we can modify this specific one. We will fill it up with tank cars. That's going to take a little while, I think, to have enough cash. And then we're going to purchase that. So we now have a train with tanks on it that is running on a brick line. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to wait for this to get past where it can turn back around, and then I'm going to put it on a different line. Add it to our crude oil line instead, and we should be able to switch it around. Lovely. Cool. So that's on its way to serve on its brand new line that we've just assigned it to. Well, the line's not brand new, but it's new for this vehicle. Now let's get cracking on converting a few more steam engines to run on diesel. Got another steam train over here running on crude oil one. And this is another one that we can get sold off completely. And we can find another GP9 on one of our mainline services to use on this one as well. Ooh, this is a good one actually, our iron ore train. Definitely we would benefit from getting that an SD40 running on that one. So we will go ahead and do that. All right, that is done. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna stop this one. And then we will get that one turned around, and we will get a few tank cars on it instead. Cool, and that one is going to be on its way with no issues whatsoever. All right, so I've done a lot of rationalization and a lot of modernizing of the fleet. We do still have a few steam trains. They're mostly the sort of newer, more powerful ones, and a lot of them are running on sort of less important lines. So we'll leave it there for the moment, but obviously we will need to finish off getting rid of steam. But there is something additional I do want to work on, and that is extending our Hollywood line. And I want to go sort of through to Charlotte here and then up to Anchorage. That will, obviously this becomes a bit of a very round route, doesn't it? From Thousand Oaks over here, Ann Arbor, and then back out to Charlotte, but that's okay. And we also have the opportunity to sort of have a direct connection as well. I also do want to go to Lexington, but we're not going to do that today. Now, an issue we have here is that we've got some lovely residential here that we're going to have to get rid of. And that is sad, but it is how life works, isn't it? So we're going to just plow straight through here. Now, what I'm going to do, I think probably towards Lexington, we might sort of break off around here, but I might potentially actually lay down part of the line, just so we know where it's going to be going. So this is where that's going to go off, head off towards Lexington, but we're not going to do anything else about that right now. We've got a bit of a slope here to go up though, don't we? Charlotte is definitely a fair bit uphill from Hollywood, and it looks like our residential is all around here, so we're in a pretty decent position to sort of run alongside that. I'm going to lay down a road here. We'll have to, unfortunately, remove a road, but it's okay. I'm just going to get rid of a couple of buildings there as well. So, and we've got some new passenger stations now as well. In fact, we might even go up to 320, and this is going to sort of start to become our, I guess, our standard length of passenger stations now. Obviously, we've got issues in that our trains are probably a little bit too short to support the number of passengers we have trying to use them, but I guess that's something we've had to learn. And let's see, can we get up the hill here? I have serious doubts we can do this, to be honest. No, so we're actually starting to tunnel as well. Okay, so that means we might need to try and build a bit more of a winding route. But everything is going to be going up as far as it can go. Even so far as to need to bridge.
What follows is a brief construction montage.
At this stage of things, I'm pretty much just building and seeing what happens. Look how expensive this is getting. Oh man, look at that. That's terrible. Well, we got the cash, so here goes nothing, I guess. When I'm building this, I'm thinking of the Dombarton line in New South Wales, here in Australia, where they've built a massive, viaduct, not unlike this one, and they just sort of ran out of money and political will to build the line, so there's just a viaduct to nowhere. This is sort of the feeling I'm getting with this line right now. So this is our own sort of Dombarton line. It is going to be, it's going to be a monument to the rail line that never was. I'm going to leave it there for the moment, but it's very clearly it's not going to work for us. So that's a good waste of recording half an episode. So instead, we're going to run to Lexington, like what was going to be our secondary line. But we are going to make it happen as a sort of a primary line now, at least for the moment anyway. And it looks like we're pretty well set up for passenger. Yeah, it's looking reasonably okay. And let's... why'd you have to build right there? Let's get a station set up for us to use. I'm somewhat sad to say I'm not giving up I'm not giving up on this yet. I wonder if we can go the other way around and if that will allow us to get up a little bit quicker or a little bit, I guess, slower really is what we're asking for. I might actually pause this so I can refund some of this if it doesn't work. Holy shit, can we do this? It's saying too much slope. I reckon that's fine though. Look, what I'm gonna do, we're gonna get rid of our old viaduct. It might leave that stretch of track there. So the question is, how far away are we from this matching up? So if we pop that to highest, it'll go. I mean, look at that. We're so close. And you know what? I'm gonna take it. We're gonna cheat a little bit, but we're gonna take it. And look at that, we built it. Oh, now we just need to duplicate it and we're good to go.
Yeah, all right. Yes.
We'll start playing again as well since we, you know, we've done what we needed to do. Now this project was absolutely batshit insane and we sort of cheated a little bit, but look, it worked in the end. We just need to cross the good old like Great Canyon over here, which, oh, that is gonna be expensive. Oh man, okay. All right, I guess the line is gonna finish here for the moment because that is way more money than I can afford and like any life. Well, what a project. And really, we've now got two sort of lines we have to service now. We need to split off our existing line at Hollywood. Needs to run to both Lexington and to Charlotte. So that's, well, a bit of a challenge, isn't it? It's not what we were planning to do in this episode, but what are we going to do there? So simple thing we're pretty much going to do here. We're going to take our Hollywood Express. We're going to add another station here at Charlotte. And of course, going back via Hollywood. Unfortunately, we can't duplicate the line. That would be really good if you could do that. At least it doesn't look like you can anyway. So this is going to be the Hollywood Express Charlotte. And then we're just going to get another one, which will be the Hollywood Express to Lexington.
Soon after.
So we now got our two lines, and what we will do, we will get our two trains that are running on the former Hollywood Express line. One will run to Lexington and one will run to Charlotte, and that should be a fairly simple solution. One very last thing I want to do before we finish off, I want to duplicate this iron ore train because we've got massive supply of iron ore and we're not really taking full advantage of it. So there should be a nice, easy duplication without too much trouble. Very nice. Well, it's been a challenging episode, but we are at the end now. I did consider, to be honest, just scrapping this episode to starting again, because I do keep, you know, saves at the end of each episode for Patreon, but I thought, well, you know what, let's just run with it, you know. I guess it's one of the pitfalls of not really planning before you do things, which honestly, while some of the things I do sometimes look really planned, sometimes, at the end of the day, I'm throwing shit at the wall and seeing what sticks. But I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell so you get a ding to your device the next time I post a video. You can find links to all my social media in the description, so please jump on there, like, follow, subscribe, do all that wonderful stuff. But until next time, I'm Bob Dendry. This is Transport Fever 2. Thank you so much for watching. And goodbye.